गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द सेकेंड लेसन ऑफ हिस्ट्री, दैट इज इंडिया बिफोर द टाइम्स ऑफ शिवाजी महाराज. डिफरेंट डायनेस्टीज हैव कम बिफोर द टाइम ऑफ शिवाजी महाराज इन इंडिया. दे आर पाल, राजपूत, चौहान, छोला डायनेस्टी, होयसल डायनेस्टी, राष्ट्रकूटा डायनेस्टी, शिलाहार डायनेस्टी एंड यादवा डायनेस्टी. Different invasions took place in India and they have ruled in India for certain time. So in this lesson we are going to study the different invasion, different dynasties, their region, their rulers, who were the rulers and what work they have done when they were ruling in India. That information we are going to study in detail in this lesson. First of all, we are going to study the invasion from the northwest. The invader from the northwest conquered the local dynasties. The Arab general Muhammad bin Qasim conquered the Sindh province in the 8th century, overcoming the resistance of King Dahir. The Turks started invading India in the 11th century CE. Sultan Muhammad of Ghazni invaded India many times. He plundered the rich temples, Mathura, Vrindavan, Kanauj and Somnath. This invasion took place in the north and west region of India. Now, Delhi Sultanate. Sultan Muhammad Ghuri invaded India from 1175 CE to 1178 CE. He appointed Qutbuddin Aibak to govern the conquered territory of India. After the death of Ghuri in 1206 CE, Aibak began to rule independently. The Delhi Sultanate ruled India up to 1526 CE. Ibrahim Lodi was the last ruler. He was defeated by Babur in the First Battle of Panipat. The significant among the rulers of Delhi Sultanate were Iltutmish, Rajia, Balban, Alauddin Khalji, Muhammad bin Tughlaq, Firoz Tughlaq and Ibrahim Lodi. Now we are going to study the kingdoms of Vijayanagar. Taking advantages of revolts against the Tughlaq Empire, Harihar and Bukka founded the Kingdom of Vijayanagar in 1336 CE in the south. Hampi was the capital of kingdom. Harihar was succeeded by Bukka. He spread his kingdom up to Rameshwar. Krishna Dev Rai ascended the throne in 1509 CE. He conquered Vijayawada in Rajmahendri. He defeated the combined armies of sultans under Bahamani Sultan Muhammad Shah. Krishna Dev Raya's kingdom extended from Cuttack in the east up to Goa in the west, of Raichur Dobh in the north, up to the Indian Ocean in the south. Krishna Dev Raya was a scholar. He wrote Amuk Malayada, a treatise on polity in Telugu language. The Hazar Ram temple and Vitthal temple was built during this time. Ramraya was the last ruler of Vijayanagar. He was defeated in 1565 CE in the battle of Talikot by Bahamani rulers. Children, now we are going to take information about Bahamani kingdom. Hasan Gango, a Sardar in defiance of Muhammad Tughlaq, founded the Bahamani kingdom in 1347 CE. Gulbarga in Karnataka was the capital of Bahamani kingdom. Muhammad Gawan was the chief wazir and his dragon, the Bahamani kingdom. He introduced many reforms, brought discipline in the army, and opened madrasas. After the death of Gawan, due to conflicts among the Sardars, the Mahamani kingdom disintegrated and 5 small kingdoms emerged. These were Imadshahi of Warad, Barishahi of Bidar, Adilshahi of Bijapur, Nizamshahi of Ahmednagar, and Qutubshahi of Golconda. This is all about Mahamani kingdom. Now children, we are going to study Mughal power. The Mughal power in India was founded by Babur in 1526 CE by defeating Ibrahim Lodi in the first battle of Panipat on 21st April 1526. Prior of founding the rule of Mughal dynasty, Babur was the king of Faragana in the Uzbekistan, Central Asia. He defeated Rana Sangha of Mewar at Khauna. Babur died in 1530 CE. Humayun was the successor of Babur. He was defeated by Sher Shah. Sher Shah founded Sur dynasty. However, Humayun managed to restore the Mughal rule in 1555 CE. After the death of Humayun in 1556 CE, Akbar came to power. He defeated Hemu in the second battle of Panipat in 1556 CE. Akbar was the most powerful Mughal ruler. He had ambition to bring the whole of India under his central authority. He had to struggle against Maharana Pratap, Chand Bibi, and Rani Durgavati. Maharana Pratap. Maharana Pratap became the ruler of Mewar after Uday Singh. He opposed Akbar imperialist policy. He is known for his qualities like valor, courage, self-respect, and sacrifice. Chand Bibi. Chand Bibi, the daughter of Hussein Nizam Shah of Ahmednagar. She bravely defeated the fort of Ahmednagar from the Mughals in 1595 CE. Due to interval strife between the Sardars of Nizamshahi, Chand Bibi was murdered. Rani Durgavati. Rani Durgavati, daughter of Chandel Rajput dynasty, became queen of Gondwana after her marriage. She laid down her life while fighting Akbar but did not surrender. Aurangzeb. Jahangir succeeded Akbar as the Mughal emperor in 1605 CE. Jahangir's wife Noor Jahan played an active role in administration. Shah Jahan succeeded Jahangir in 1628 CE and ruled India till his death in 1658 CE. Aurangzeb was the last noteworthy Mughal emperor who ruled India from 1658 CE to 1707 CE. Aurangzeb expanded the Mughal Empire, but the Mughal Empire became weak after his death. Children, now we are going to take information about the Ohams. Ohams were the people of Shan community who settled down in the valley of a river, Brahmaputra. They were known as the Ohams. The Ohams, under the leadership of Ganda Sina, they have intense fight with the Mughal. Due to the guerrilla technique of Oham, the Mughal could not defeat Ohams. Now, children, we are going to take information about the Sikh. Children, now we are going to take information about the Sikh. Guru Tej Bahadur protested against the policy of religious tolerance of Aurangzeb. He was imprisoned and afterwards he was beheaded in 1675 CE. Guru Gobind Singh organized the Sikh youth into Khalsa Dal to fight with Aurangzeb. However, they did not succeed. Later, Guru Gobind Singh succumbed to his wounds in Nanded. The last dynasty is known as the Rajput. Durgadas Rathore, after the death of Rana Jaswant Singh, fought against the Mughal for the survival of the Marwad region. So children, this is all about the different dynasties which were ruling in India before the birth of Shivaji Maharaj. After this lecture, I am going to write an assignment, the answer of the questions, children, you need to write in your classwork notebook. Thank you.